In today's short video, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know to be able to adjust any carburetor on a weed eater without a tachometer and cover some essential points that I haven't seen mentioned anywhere else on YouTube. I'll also include this flowchart that I made throughout the video to know exactly where you are in the process, and there's a link in the description below if you want to download and save a copy as well. The first step in the process is to make sure that the air filter is clean, the fuel filter is clean, the tank is full, and that the line is set about an inch below its maximum length. Now, there are two different styles that are found on weed eaters, and they're both adjusted differently. One is known as a butterfly type carburetor, and the other is a rotary. And I'll show you how to adjust both in today's video, starting with the butterfly type. Now, there are three screws found on most carburetors. You have a low speed screw, a high speed screw, and an idle speed screw. With the low speed screw closest to the engine and the high speed screw closest to your air filter. Some adjustment screws can be done using a simple flathead screwdriver, where others have a special profile in which to fit. Therefore, I've put links to both the kit that I use in the description below, as well as a more budget-friendly alternative as well. Adjusting the carburetor, in this case on a Stihl branded weed eater, I can do so with a simple flathead screwdriver, and I start by turning the low and high speed screws in clockwise until they fully seat, but only gently, don't force them, and then turn them both back out 1 1/4 turns. And to set the starting point for the idle screw, we turn it out anti-clockwise until it no longer touches the cam in which it rests against. We then turn it back in until it just touches the cam once again, and then go 1 1/4 turns further in. Now, you may find that your carburetor has what are known as limiter caps. These are plastic covers that go over the high and low speed fuel screws, and they limit your adjustability. Therefore, simply prise those off with a screwdriver, and then we can refit them at the end of the procedure. With those initial adjustments in place, we can start and warm up the weed eater for a few minutes, and we'll vary the RPM as well. Now, the first step in the adjustment procedure is to turn the idle speed screw in clockwise until the head of the weed eater just starts to turn. From here, we turn that same screw, the idle speed screw, back out until the head just stops rotating. Now we move over to the low speed screw, and we're going to turn that screw in and back out until we find the point at which the engine runs the fastest. At this point, you may notice that the head of the weed eater has started to rotate again, and therefore we lower the engine speed with the idle screw until it just stops turning. Now, because we've made that idle adjustment, it's really important now that we go back to the low speed screw and once again find that point at which the engine runs the fastest. And we repeat this process as many times as it takes. We find the fastest RPM on the low speed screw. If the head is rotating, we reduce the engine speed with the idle screw until we've got the fastest engine speed without the head rotating. Now, the next and final adjustment we need to make to the low speed screw is to turn it out anti-clockwise until the engine just starts to come down to a nice smooth rumble. And typically it's only about 1/8 to 1/4 of a turn that's needed. Now, that completes the adjustment for the low speed circuit, and the throttle butterfly position, and the engine should start and it should idle without any trouble. Now we're going to move on to the high-speed side of the carburetor, and we need to go to full throttle first, and then we're going to turn the high-speed screw in very gradually, clockwise, until the engine goes from running rough, which I'll refer to as four-stroking, to running smooth, which we'll refer to as two-stroking. And now the final step on the high speed adjustment is to turn that screw back out, but very gradually and slowly, until the engine just starts to break up and four stroke once again. I'll show you that high speed adjustment procedure as one complete process now, so you can hear the difference between four stroking and two stroking, and then you'll have a reference for adjusting your carburetors at home. Now, one last and incredibly important point on adjusting the high-speed screw of the carburetor, and it's something I haven't seen anyone else on YouTube mention. If you find that as you turn the high-speed screw in to lean the engine out, and you never hear the engine change from four-stroking to two-stroking, you may have what is known as a limited ignition coil. In these instances, turn the high-speed screw in gradually until you can hear the pitch and the rhythm of the engine just change, and it's really subtle. You can leave it there, it's safe to do so, and there's no need to turn that screw back out once again like before. Have a listen now to what that sounds like. I mentioned earlier about the rotary style carburetor, the alternative that you might find on your weed eater, and there are some important differences when it comes to tuning them. The first difference is the location of the adjustment screws. Now, the high speed is still found on the side of the carburetor, but the low speed is actually found at the top in the center of the barrel, which rotates. And lastly, the idle speed is just off to one side of the low speed screw, up at the top. We set the starting position of these screws just like we did on the butterfly carburetor. We turn the low and high speed screws in until they lightly seat, and then turn them back out 1¼ turns. And on the idle screw, we back it out until it no longer touches the cam in which it rests against, and then we turn it back in until it first touches it, and then go a further 1¼ turns in. The next difference is we actually set the high speed adjustment screw first before the low. Rotary carburetors are dependent fuel systems, and that means that all of the fuel has to flow past the high speed adjustment screw before it gets to the low speed. Therefore, any adjustment of the high speed screw will affect how the engine runs at idle, and it can cause you to chase your tail going back and forth between the two. Setting that high speed screw first limits the maximum amount of fuel that the engine can get, and we can fine tune that with the low speed screw afterwards. And just as before, we're going to start and warm the engine up for just a few minutes, varying the throttle. And now we can go right to full throttle, and we'll turn that high speed screw in gradually until the engine goes from running rough to running smooth, and then back the high speed screw out just slightly until the engine starts to run rough once again. And don't forget, once again, some of these machines do have limited ignition coils, and they are set just like I mentioned on the butterfly type carburetor earlier. And now we've completed the high speed adjustment, we can move on to the low, and you might find that there's a rubber bung on the top of that low speed stopping you from getting access. So put a hot pick inside that bung, and when it cools down, you'll pull the pick out and the rubber bung will come out with it. Now, setting the low speed circuit on a rotary carburetor is very similar to a butterfly. Bring that engine idle speed up until the head starts to rotate. Turn the idle speed screw back out now until that head just stops turning. And now we can turn that low speed screw in and out to find the point at which the engine runs its fastest. And once again, if at that point the head is starting to rotate, we lower the engine speed with the idle screw, and then we repeat that process of adjusting both the idle screw and the low speed screw until we find the point at which the engine is running the fastest and the head is no longer spinning. The last difference is that we don't need to turn that low speed fuel screw back out like we did with the butterfly carburetor. These rotary carburetors offer a much more consistent fuel supply across the range, and they don't suffer with the same problems of that bog and that dip off of idle when you first pull that trigger. Therefore, instead, we're going to lower the engine speed using the idle screw this time until it just comes down to a nice hum. When a two-stroke engine's carburetor is adjusted incorrectly, there's a very good chance that you'll damage that engine completely. However, not all hope is lost, and if you do come across a damaged engine, I've got this video for you next on how you can save it.